the spices you're going to be using. So we have chili powder, paprika, cinnamon, and allspice. Brown sugar and cider vinegar. Again, that's a typical basic spices to use for ketchup. Then you can add one.
And then what's the, like, once your onions are translucent, you can go ahead and add your tomatoes.
To complement.
Obviously, you probably won't use a grape a lot.
Does
the
ketchup taste
bigger
depending on the tomato?
Yeah, I mean, if Roma would be a little bit more milder, bigger ones have a little bit more juice here and there. But it would overly matter because you're going to have the tomato paste, and the tomato paste will give it really a more of a wild flavor to it.
What tomatoes did you say?
These are Roma tomatoes. So you're going to want to cook down the tomatoes, add a little pepper, a little salt for now. Just try to, you always, if you're going to do this at first, try not to add too much seasonings at first. Because, you know, at the end of the product, it might be too salty, or it might have too much sugar in it. So always add a little at first, and then at the end, you could always, you know, put, you know, extra seasonings in there.
90 days, it's cooked, you know, always. And you have, you know, sugar, acidity, and everything. So it's just, it's a perfect thing for conservation, you know, things like this. So again, if you don't eat, you know, the jar of ketchup in 90 days, you're doing good.